Thank you. Thank you so much for coming out to help us to understand more about social justice. I have a concern to bring up, and it's really hard for me to say this because my hands are sweaty and I'm really nervous, but I'm just a regular citizen. Something has come up in our community, in my town. There are private property owners that are poor in nature that their property has been rezoned from homeowners,
residential,
thank you, to commercial. I don't believe that they have been truly educated before this has happened. I'm concerned that their taxes are going to go up and that they're going to lose their private property.
It's okay, take your time.
It's called gentrification, where they clean out the community for something called sustainable development, something for mixed-use housing, where they want no more private property ownership, where they want businesses on the bottom, offices in the middle, and living quarters on top, where they want no private ownership, but more private industry ownership or private corporation ownership, or but not private personal people ownership, with their yards and their homes that they've built and that they've lived on all their life. Unless they're 65 years and older, their taxes are going to go up. And I don't think they understand that. I don't think that they've been properly briefed and educated. But I'm just a citizen. I don't know what to do. I don't know how to shout it from the mountaintop that this injustice is occurring. But thank you. All of you can answer as you can. Thank you.
I think you run for office, just like I do.
What town is that? Ocean Spring, Mississippi. You know what? Sometimes this is old stuff, but it's still happening. When your community becomes discovered, and if it's thought that it's too good for the incumbent residents, the people who are there and have been there all along, then there's a process that goes on, and oftentimes the people that are in the communities are the last to find out about the rezoning. And what happened is that in some cases you have to sue the bastards. You need lawyers. There are rules and there are laws in terms of having to have public hearing, notice of public hearings and public hearings about transfers. This is old stuff. You know, in the 50s it had urban renewal, and there was a joke called Negro removal. Today, you know, you have the fact that if you are in an area where there's prime real estate, and it's now seen as I said, too valuable for you, for the residents there, and they're talking about, and they're calling the nice names of new urbanism, smart growth. They're telling that, but it is a form of expulsive zoning. Expulsive from the standpoint of you gotta go because you don't fit the new profile. And so I think that has to be challenged, and people have to realize that there are some hooks that you can hang, and a lot of them are legal, but also a lot of them are getting the information out so they can be, the public response can be such that, well, how is this kind of action to be allowed in this day and time? And it's happening, you know, not just in Ocean Spring, but it's happening in Atlantic Beach, you know, in Florida, last black beach in Florida, and, you know, it's too good to be, you know, for black people, and surrounded by condominiums. They see this little black beach as, oh, that's prime property for condominiums. Or Hilton Head, South Carolina, all those islands used to be inhabited just by Geechies. Black folks who ran away from slavery into the swamp infested, then they discovered, hey, this is a nice place for golf courses. Now the black people who live on some of those islands have to carry ID cards and get permission to cross over. So I think you have to, you know, you need allies, and if you don't have resources in the community, there are places that you can turn to get support from organizations that do pro bono legal, and there are other experts that do this kind of work. So I'm thinking that, you know, if I can put you in touch with some people that may help. I don't think it's too late if you're still, you know, if you're still there. You're still there, right? Then it's not too late.
You might also want to talk to some of your neighbors. Never underestimate the power of the few, because people may feel the same way as you do. And if you start in small groups, you might find other people want to get together and do the same thing.